My God!
An SBS that is quite meaty, quite hefty, and giving us One Piece fans the necessary nutrients and proteins for our One Piece body and our One Piece minds. People, this SBS is pretty good. When it comes to what Oda's telling us, it's pretty good. Granted, some things I figure like, okay, well, why not just tell us an actual story? But at the same time, that only applies to like one or two things. Other things, though, oh yeah, now I'm very intrigued. Now you have my attention. Absolutely you do. And then there's some weird, because listen, Oda's a pervert. No matter what anyone tells you, he's absolutely a pervert. Make no mistake, when you have folks literally in this SBS talking about eating Oda's Kibi Dango. Oda is a pervert. Make no mistakes about that. So there's a lot of stuff going on in this SBS that is pretty crazy, pretty funny. But we have, a lot of good things too. Talking about YouTubers, talking about Doflamingo, talking about Luffy, and what could be going down maybe with Luffy in the future, as well as Strike Double Fruits, and what is actually a spoiler. Like, what is a full-on spoiler? Which we didn't necessarily know. I mean, well, okay, it's assumed to be the case, because that's what we see, but it's like confirmed now in SBS. So there are various things in SBS that I think are very, very good overall. And let's go through the main things. Though I will say, off the gate, number one, the full thing is in the description box down below on the Library of Horror. That's number one. Number two is that there is an entire thing for the Marines. And I'm happy to say, no Kong involved, because Kong is trash. Worst character in One Piece. Probably by far. But we'll save Kong's punk ass for another damn day. Oh, yeah. Kong Sucks is coming. Make no mistake. Kong Sucks is absolutely coming. Ugh. Trash. Now, that being said, onto the fun stuff. Onto the good stuff. The first thing I think of substance that we get in this SBS is question number 8. If Luffy's Gear 4 is a thing, then will Gear 5 be a thing too? And it is clearly written with such impact, with such fluent script, with such elegance, that Oda had no choice but to respond. So shoutouts to Y Shosei-kun, because I wanna see this too. Very well. Seeing the passion in your handwriting, I feel obliged to include this question just as I received it. A note to self, because my handwriting sucks. Will 5 be a thing? Right now, the enemy we have to defeat is a man said to essentially be the world's strongest. Because of that, the world is in an age of transitioning from 4G to 5G. G means gear, right? Oh, no. First of all, I do need to get a new phone because I have a 6S. Yo, this thing sucks, man. Number two, 5 gear. 5th gear. Interesting. Not talking about a new variant of Gear 4, but talking about a whole new Gear 5. This, I think, could, if there's going to be a Gear 5, it could be a Gear 4 combo variant, maybe. Where some folks theorize that Gear 5 is going to be a combination of Gear 3 plus Gear 2 plus Gear 4. Some kind of crazy Attack on Titan Luffy. Another theory is only Gear 4 is combined to one genuine gear. So let's say a Gear 5 is a combination of Bowman, Snake Man, and Tank Man. I would go for the Tiger Man thing where it could be a Gear 5 Tiger Man. I did a video on that one like a while ago. However, if not, any of that stuff. And like, let's say it's going to be a whole new thing. Then either it has to be A, Conqueror's Haki related, or B, Awakening related. Awakening related. Luffy may genuinely awaken his abilities, or maybe he's actually grasped some degree of awakening off screen. Oh. Because keep in mind, we have seen his Duffy kind of change a bit. Now we're seeing the Kong Gatling rather than the Kong Organ. And previously in the past, we did see Luffy use a Gear 3 in a way, but without actually blowing into his hand. So Luffy could be in the precipice of actually achieving Awakening, which could be a Gear 5. So Oda, Gear 5, Gear 4 variants, oh yeah, they're in play. Which means to me that there's still a lot to come for this fight against Kaido and Big Mom. But mainly Kaido, because he's specifically referring to Kaido as the enemy here. Not Big Mom. Very interesting. Now, the next thing here is this. Oda talks about Doflamingo in question 13. Oda's asked the question about the Kaido Pirates or the Beast Pirates named after card games. And he says, yes, indeed, the three all-stars are pretty obvious, but all the Flying Six, the numbers, the headliners, only excluding Drake, Apu, and Hawkins, which is actually very intriguing too, because Drake, Diaz Drake, X Drake, Drake be the 10. But no, excluding Drake, Apu, and Hawkins are all named after card games as well as K, King, Q, Queen, J, Jack, and 1 to 10 cards. So you have Who's Who, Black Mirror, OT, Page One, Sasaki, Hold'em, and Babanuki, Old Maid. Now, very intriguing right here. If I were to list them all, I'll be filling out this entire page. I imagine some of you might go, I've never heard of this one before, in regards to many of these games. But there are many ways to play with cards all over the world. By the way, in Dressrosa, Doflamingo being called Joker is a remnant of an idea where Doflamingo was going to fight as a powerful companion of Kaido in the Wano country. He was quite the tricky opponent, so I'm glad we got rid of him at Dressrosa. And right here, according to Arter's notes, here Doflamingo is called Nakama. So it's unclear if Oda was referring to Doflamingo acting as an ally or as Kaido's subordinate. This is very interesting because the Joker card is the outlier card for many card games. So Doflamingo, or Joker in this case, being not necessarily like a part of the crew, but being an ally of the Beast Pirates, and him and his crew act as their own individual entities in this situation is very, very intriguing. Just as Apu is known to be Kaido's informant, not necessarily a full-on member of the Beast Pirates, but maybe more so an ally. So that being said, Doflamingo being in Dressrosa, I think would be interesting to see him. Of course, I'd argue he'd get handled with the Strike's new power-ups. Though, to be fair, if he was, let's say, a subordinate, I could... Even though it goes against my power dynamic, I can kind of see to where, let's say, King and Queen, they always dunk on Jack. I can see Jack taking out his frustrations on... Oh, man. I can see it happening, dude. Like, Jack gets mad at Doflamingo because he's mad that his brother's mad at him. I'm sorry, brothers. I'm sorry, Anikis. Doflamingo's like, oh, Jack, what's going on? It's like, Grusei! It's like, oh, Aniki, gomenasai. Now, of course, obviously, given Doflamingo's personality, he would two-face that. And then once Jack leaves, he'll be like, yo, this goddamn punk, I'm gonna kill him one day. But I ain't gonna front. I can see definitely Doflamingo walking on shards, walking on thin ice if he's gonna be around Jack, Queen, and King, even like the Flying Six doing punk stuff. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Or maybe actually, you know, actually, hold on, but it could be the reverse case too, because Doflamingo is like the main smile guy. Though, to be fair, if he can insult. Kaido's insulting Doflamingo of being weak. So either or, all right, either or. But I can just see it. Like, it would be so funny. Just Jack dunking on Doflamingo because Jack is mad that King and Queen are mad at him. I get it'd be hilarious. Now, questions 10 and 11 are YouTuber stuff, which is very intriguing. So right here, question 10. Hey everyone, so I made a little blunder. I lost the postcard, or was it a letter? A reader sent me, sorry, but it's fine because I remember the contents. It was from a fellow with the PN, Ian Kun, I think I said that name, who asked me to take a look at his YouTube channel. It seems he does videos where he crafts One Piece figures. I thought I recognized one of the figures, and I realized it was because he previously submitted to the Usopp Pirates Gallery. It's pretty fun to think some readers have become YouTubers. So please give Ian a look. Go look at the channel. Ah, I've heard they did a collab with Sanadachi, but you're better off not watching that. So this guy gets some love from Oda in the SBS YouTubers. We've known for some time now, but YouTubers have had an influence, at least the Japanese ones. Look at that. Japanese YouTubers have had some influence on Oda's editors and Oda himself. And Sanadachi, I think, is one of the key ones, absolutely, because the man makes an appearance in the next question. right here. So I was studying about old mixed baths and heard that back in the day, anytime young women would come in, the grannies would protect them because the perverted bastard Odachi would be approaching. Sheesh, you perverted bastard. Always getting in trouble. Anyways, I just wanted to let you know I'm changing my residence to a to a bathhouse. P.N. Sanadachi. Now wait a minute.
Now wait a minute.
We're not done yet. Because Oda pervs out, the man starts mentioning cock and ball pummeling. Wait.
Oh, okay. No!
Look, I don't know what Oda's wife does to him on the regular, but it is... Listen. Hey, hold up, grannies. You're in the way. I can't get there if you block me. You're stopping me from seeing what I want to see. This is infringing on my rights. I won't stand for it. Ouch! Wait, hold up. Stop with the fucking ball torture. Ouch! Stop! Stop!
That is crazy.
Stop corrupting the SBS, Sanada! Listen.
Look, listen!
You call Sanada a rascal with these grannies. Grannies go fucking ball torture him. This man is referring to fucking ball torture twice. I think Oda is low key. He's being funny, right? And again, Oda himself is a pervert, without question. Without question. Anyways, yeah, to anyone who has heard about this thinking it was because of perverts, even all the way back in ancient time, people still felt embarrassed about bathing together, so older women would make sure young women... Yeah, listen.
Look here.
He's mentioning cock and ball torture twice in a fun way, but low-key, low-key, in S&M play, I get the feeling... Especially when you see all the girls, like Nami, beat up like Sanji and Zoro all the time for like doing stupid stuff. I get the feeling.
Yeah, boy.
Clear as crystal.
To each their own. To each their own. Alright? I ain't gonna diss on that. Listen, he's Gota. He is allowed to do whatever the hell he wants to do. Oda, we see you. Oda, we see you. Okay. Now, on to the next one. And this one's a very important one. My man, Sanji. My main man, Sanji. I mean, what's Sanji being a CB? Oh, I don't wanna. No. Stop it. Do not. Not that many folks will get this far into the video. And I'm happy that's the case. I'm really happy. Don't timestamp it. Don't say anything in the comment section. Nothing. Question 16. Please draw the perv... Sanji, age 40 and 60 in the future, please. I'm counting on you. PN, Gomu Nara no Mi. Very well. I received many requests about this. Enjoy. This is awesome. I have never seen a future where things went wrong so dope among all the characters other than Sanji. So, where it went right. Whether it's women or food, I ain't picky. I'm gonna go fish in the all blue. Those are really damn dope. Where the future went wrong, as long as it fills the belly, all food's the same. Which actually coincides a lot more with Sanji's thing, because he eats food that tastes bad. Dude, look at this. Bro. For when things went wrong for a character, you can't tell me that's not cool. That's actually, it's Judge! Dude! The second coming of, he has an S helmet! Drain the poison into the sea. He's just Judge! Now granted, of course he hates Judge, obviously. So for him, Sanji would hate that. But for us, at least for me, that's cool as all hell. I ain't gonna front. Sanji has a good outcome, no matter which option. Which is dope. I ain't gonna front. I like that. I like that a lot. That's really damn cool. 40-year-old Sanji, his hair is over his left eye. And then 60-year-old Sanji, now it's over his right eye. Like, they're flipping all the damn time. 40-year-old Sanji, when the future goes wrong, we don't see his eyes at all. And then in the 61, we see now both eyes. So it's kind of... Basically, in the future where things go right, Sanji always has one eye covered. That's essentially what it boils down to. And then finally, the last thing. Something that's actually very, very damn dope. The Straw Hat Crew Devil Fruits. So in this, no Robin, no Brook, no Chopper, no Jinbei, actually, because he's actually, huh, no Jinbei. But no Robin, no Brook, no Chopper, no Luffy, because they're at the fruits, obviously. If Zoro, Nami, Usopp, Sanji, Franky were to become Builder users, then what kind of fruit do you think they would have eaten? I see. That's quite a fun question. What I would like to see is Zoro with the Ui Ui no Mi, the fish fruit, mythical type, model Seiryu. And then counter underneath him. I'd want the sword to turn into a dragon rather than Zoro. I think that would be insanely cool. Model Seiryu. That is the first time you've gotten the actual model name. So this proves that Kaido was not a Magikarp and then became a Gyarados. No. The model is a actual dragon. Like I've been saying, I don't think, even though it's a meme, I don't think that Kaido was a fish.
A fish?
Like a koi fish that go up the waterfall. No. And then he became a dragon because that's part of the mythology. No. That's not how that works. Once he ate the fruit, he was a dragon from jump. He was a dragon from jump. Not a fish, not a Gyarados, no aquatic shit going on there. He was a dragon from jump. And the Seiryu is a blue dragon, which is noted specifically in Arthur's notes. And also, if you didn't know, because I know, because, you know, Yu Yu Hakusho, baby.
Let's try again.
The Azure Dragon is one of the four mythical beasts that guard Japan. Maybe it's Kyoto specifically. Maybe it's Kyoto specifically. But either way, the four beasts are the Azure Dragon of the East, the Vermilion Bird of the South, the White Tiger of the West, and the Black Turtle of the North. So now going on from there, Nami has the Goro Goro no Mi, the Rumble Rumble Fruit, Lightning Human. She'd be NL, basically. A true weather lady now, no one can stop her anymore apart from Luffy. All the theories, I remember all the theories about Nami eating like Monet's snow ability, the Yuki Yuki Princess Nami. Ugh, well, or I guess now that shifted over to Carrot. But either way, no, that's all said and gone. But it makes sense, Nami controlling the weather, a lightning human, NL's powers. Ugh, Mike, I mean, listen. I love NL, but Nami, again, Robin exists, Robin's better, but lightning powers of Nami, that would sway me to, that would sway me just a bit, okay? So, Usopp, with the Poke Poke no Mi, the Pokeball no Mi, the Pocket Pocket fruit, infinite pockets in one's body, the perfect pocket for someone like Usopp who always has something up his sleeve. Awesome. Sanji, the Sui Sui no Mi, the swim fruit. It allows one to slip through walls or swim on the ground. If given to Sanji, it become quite the nasty ability. Yes. That is genius. So my man can slip under the ground and just peep in the bathrooms and look up the skirts and be the absolute perv that we know. Yes, you know what? For a young man in the springtime of his youth, how can you not applaud such actions? Oda's, his creativity knows no bounds. Yes, Oda giving Sanji an ability and spinning it to be so perverted. Ugh, love it. Love it, love it, love it. And also, too, on Zoro's case, Zoro swore to be a dragon, not necessarily Zoro himself, which is very intriguing. So, Zoro has, like, dragon-ish skills. Like, we have the Flying Dragon Blaze, we have the Dragon Twister. How would these things work if he had a dragon, like, an actual dragon, living dragon sword? It'd be kind of crazy, actually. Like, could Zoro's sword, like, also jettison out fire waves? Like, or like, emit lightning? It'd be kind of dope. And then finally, Franky with the Buki Buki no Mi, the arms arm fruit. Can't get any better than this for an ability for Franky. Honestly, that's true. That's just straight up factual. Franky would come out like an actual Gundam. Franky would come out like Chibity Crockett. I guarantee you. Like from G Gundam. Chibity Crockett. From Neo. From Neo America. He would come out with a full blown Gundam if he had that ability. Absolutely. It would be so epic. It would be phenomenal. I'm begging someone out there in the ether, in the internet, make it happen. Chibity Crockett Franky. I would love that. I would love that. You'd have my heartfelt blessings for eternity. And on that note, that is the SBS Corner question number 98. This SBS is something that's really, really good. From YouTubers to Delphi Powers, all these different things, I like what I see through and through. I am in front. This was a fun SBS to read through, and I would say a very memorable SBS for me personally. I'm looking forward to 99 and 100, mainly 100, because I want to see the questions I was going to answer in that one. Honestly, I do. So on that note, guys and gals, I'm going to see you on the flip side. You guys and gals, take care. Make sure to stay safe, be easy, And have a nice one.